Hello, dear students. Very good morning to all of you. I think you must be okay all. So before starting today's lecture, let us recall the before class first. As per your before class, already we have finished the detail about the shift register. And that shift register is one type of sequential device, digital device by which we can store or we can use for memory device. And already we have finished in that lecture what is register, where register and why register, and the detailed classification of registers, and also the different types of classification or types of register. Under that already we have finished the major four types of register. Then in next class already we have finished individual shift register, CISO, SIPO, like that. Then finally we stop that class at the application of shift register. That section was one type of sequential circuit that is known as the shift register. If you have any doubt, we can discuss in a doubt clearing class over that, but focus on today's class. Today's class is also about another important type of sequential circuit. You know what is sequential circuit? Because as per your syllabus, already we have divided the total digital devices into broad classes. One is combinational digital circuit, another sequential digital circuit. So under the sequential digital circuit, counter is also one type of sequential digital circuit. So before starting this portion, let us go through the outline of today's class. Today's class is mostly focusing over the counter. Then before entering into the counter, first of all we have to discuss what we are and why. Then we discuss about different classification of or different types of counters. Then how we implement some major or fundamental counters. All implementation of counter is not possible for a single class, but we focus here the main category of counter or one type of counter in this class. So let us start. So before implementing a particular design, first of all we have to know what is counter. As per its name, counter counts a counter, just like run and runner. You know what is the meaning of run and what is the meaning of runner. Like that, counter, count, from the word count we can take the word counter. So now you can design your definition by yourself. Not required to follow any material or anything. You can write yourself a definition if you apply some idea. So let us put that idea. Counter. Here this is the sequential circuit. Accordingly we can take counter is a sequential type of digital circuit that can count, or that is used for counting purpose. Which type of count? Mostly as for this discussion, the counting will be over the number of occurrence of an event, or number of clock pulses in a signal, or number of frequencies, like that. So basically its major definition is, major meaning is, it can be used for counting the number of occurrence of an event. Number of occurrence of an event means how many times that event is happening, or number of sequence of an event, or number of clock pulses in a clock source or signal source, like that. So now clear, first of all it is a digital device, then it is a sequential type of digital device, then third it is used for counting purpose, then fourth which type of count? Counting number of occurrence of an event, or number of clock pulses of a signal, or number of any number of sequence we can count by this device. Then next, that counter actually designated. Already we know the meaning, but how we designate a counter? So let us discuss. Basically the counter, as for your before slide, the designation is n bit or mod n counter. Basically counters are designated by n bit mod n counter. In two ways we can designate. either you can take the designation by n bit counter, or we can designate by modulus m or mod m counter. So what is the meaning of n bit and modulus? N bit now see n bit means suppose in a counter you have total number of counting sequence 8 total number of counting sequence 8 so it will start counting from 0 to 7 so its last count is 7 so accordingly total number of count is 8 so for total number of count 8 what should be the number of bits in each count 3 because there is a relation between number of bits and total number of count 2 to the power 3 equal to 8 3 is indicating the bit value 8 is indicating the total number of counting sequence so this is one example now you can designate the counter either 3 bit counter or mod 8 counter 3 bit counter or mod 8 counter now return to standard definition so n bit means n indicates the number of bits in a particular counting sequence and m indicates the modulus value of the counter what is the modulus value of counter modulus value of counter means the total number of counting sequence or a total number of occurrence of an event suppose m is as for this example your m is 8 then n will be 3 so how we designate this counter either we can designate this counter as a 3 bit counter or mod 8 counter or modulus 8 counter briefly it is taken as mod 8 counter now clear how we are designating so we can designate either in bit form or in modulus form bit indicate the number of bits in individual counting sequence modulus indicates the total number of counting sequence that counter can count so as an example if we consider the 3 bit counter then its n value is 3 and modulus value is 8 similarly another example we can take to be very clear suppose you have a mod 16 counter mod 16 counter then another name for this you can put 4 bit counter same meaning so what is the meaning here mod 16 means this counter can count total number of sequence 16 its total number of counting sequence is 16 and it can able to count from 0 0 0 0 or in decimal from 0 to 15 it can count from 0 to 15 in decimal form then in each count if we shift to binary form then total 16 number of counting sequence means starting from 0 0 0 to 1 1 1 1 or decimally 0 to 15 this is the mod meaning and what is the bit meaning now in each counting you have 4 bits like that similarly you can take mod 4 mod 5 mod 6 or mod any mod value we can take but the standard form is mod 8 and mod 16 as per your syllabus and very important for your semester exam is mod 8 and mod 16 you must get a 10 mark question either over the mod 8 or over the mod 16 as per your SCTPT semester exam so now we are considering only the standard counters not any reduced counter standard counter means the relation between modulus and bit value will be like this only focus today's class is focusing over this the counters having the relation between modulus and bit m is equal to 2 to the power n so accordingly two examples over here then modulus and bit relation already over m is equal to 2 to the power n that relation also help you in getting the number of flip flops used in a counter. That will be discussed in later. Now see, now you already have over what is the meaning of counter, then where counter. These are the list where we get the counter in our daily life. You must be well known about these factors. Now see, in calculators, without counter, calculator is not functioning or not doing anything. Microprocessor also, all types of computer system and processors and a clock, all are using the counters. Also in your home appliances, you get the counter. Your washing machine is taking the reading, time reading or sequence reading, that is also a count by counter. Then in address, without counter, address or memory device is memory. You have a memory device and within the memory you have to put an address for each location, and that address have a descending order, and also you try to return in a either you try to move in a ascending order or you try to go through a descending order. Both type of movement is required in memory device. So accordingly, how is it possible, how we are ascending our memory location or incrementing our memory location, and how we decrement our memory location, that is possible due to the use of a counter. Then accordingly, address, increment and decrement also. Then counting, different counting applications, so many counting applications. Then in PLC programming, input output signal, in PLC also you have to use the counter. In detail we have to take a special class over the counter. How all these cases are involving the counter, that will be separate class. Then arithmetical circuit, in within the ALU also we get the counter. So these are the fields. Some fields, so more fields are also available. It is not possible to discuss all in a single class. So these are the fields where easily we can understand the presence of counter, and over this we have a special class arrangement in future, and we discuss practically how they are involved in different cases. Then why counter? Why you are using counter? From the before list already you have realized why counter. But above all, now see, actually for counting, counter is required. And for frequency divider circuit, suppose you have a large frequency signal and you try to divide it by 50%, by 1/4%, like that. So by applying a signal to a counter, you can divide your frequency. Then time period measurement also you can use the counter. You have a signal, you try to know the time period. So within the lab you can verify all this, how we measure the time period by the counter. Also in theory class, from the waveform we can realize this thing. Then designing digital triangular wave generator. Triangular wave generator may be counter, counter can be used. Then arithmetical operations. No arithmetic function is possible by counter. Then counter also used in analog to digital conversion. Also counter is helpful in analog to digital conversion. So signal converter also includes the counter. This application and this portion will be covered under your ADC and DAC chapter. You have also analog to digital converter and digital to analog converter chapter, and in that chapter you can realize this portion. I'll show you the presence of this. Then next, this is about the classification of counter. The counter can be classified broadly three classes. Broadly three. The one is series counter, another is parallel counter, and third one is combinational counter. So series counter again can be divided into two classes, up counter and a down counter. Parallel counter also can be divided into up counter and a down counter. Then combinational counter is the something different from the two standard form. So first of all, focus on today's series counter. Series counter, as per its name, in this case the counter is designed in such a manner that we have to realize a relation of series connection. So before that, first of all we have to consider how we construct the registers, sorry, counters. Counters are basically consisting of flip-flops, combination of flip-flops. Those flip-flops are basically major design contains the cascading of the flip-flops. And the number of flip-flops in a counter depends on the number of bit of a counter. Suppose you have to design an n-bit counter, then you have to take n number of flip-flops. Suppose you have to design a 16-bit counter, then you have to take 16 the 16-bit counter, accordingly you have to use the 16 number of flip-flops. But if you have to design a mod 16 counter, please remember some difference here. Either you are taking the designation mod m or bit. If you are taking the bit designation, the number of bits indicate the number of flip-flops. But if you are using the modulus value, mod 16 means you have to use 4 counters, because 16 is equal to 2 to the power 4. So, it will be better first remember in terms of a bit, we can take the number of flip-flops. So, in a series counter, actually those flip-flops are connected in series, and the clock input, main source clock input, is applied to the first flip-flop. The output of first flip-flop used as the clock input for the second flip-flop. The second flip-flop output acts as the clock input for the third flip-flop, like that. So, serially here we have to apply the clock input. It's series counter. So, this counter also has alternative names like ripple counter, serial counter, then asynchronous counter. So, let us start then. Over this circuit we can realize all these meanings. So, series, from the name of series, one flip-flop output is connected to the input, clock input of the next. Accordingly, the name is series counter. Basically, in this counter, the main features are like this. This is, in this case, one flip-flop output is acting as the clock input for the next flip-flop. Accordingly, all the flip-flops are not triggered or clocked simultaneously. Second flip-flop is waiting for getting the clock pulse from the first. Third flip-flop is waiting to get the clock pulse from the second. So, accordingly, it is not simultaneously triggered or simultaneously not clocked. So, this is a asynchronous device where we are not applying the clock input directly, simultaneously. That is known as asynchronous device. So, this is an asynchronous type counter. So, accordingly, its propagation delay time is additive, waiting for next. But it is simple and straightforward, and also its circuit is very simple and very easy to implement for any mod value. Then, slow with counting errors. Only its major demerit is some counting errors, and also you have to wait and very slow, like that. So, let us take a simple design, mod 4 or a 2-bit counter. Now, see, mod 4 means total number of counting sequence is 4. Total number of sequence 4 means it starts counting from 0 and max last count is 3. So, accordingly, it can able to count from 0 to 3, but next again it returns to, this is the decimal equivalency and this is the binary equivalency. So, it can able to count from 0 to 1. Next, it will repeat the same count. So, first of all, from its name, mod 4 and 2-bit, so we can write two lines about this. First point is definition. It is a such type of series counter that can count maximum 4 number of sequence. The sequences are starting from 0 to 3, or in binary form, from 00 to 11. Then the bits, number of bits in each count is 2. Now this is your truth table. So here we are using for counting the clock pulse as an example. Suppose this is your clock input and you are applying the clock source. Now see, another point also recall, the number of bits indicate the number of flip-flops. So here 2-bit means 2 flip-flops. Now our design is considered by taking the JK flip-flops. The two flip flops we have to take, and the JK flip flop to act as a counter. Always the J and K inputs are connected to logic 1. That means J equal to 1 and K equal to 1 state is utilized in counter case. Because when J equal to 1, K equal to 1, please recall your flip-flop class. Particularly special class over the flip-flop. How the function of JK flip-flop under the state J equal to 1 and K equal to 1. It will toggle at this state. In counter, basically we are utilizing this condition. Please remember, we are not considering the four states. Only here we are considering J equal to K equal to 1. So accordingly, first connect these two to high or 1. Then the main clock pulse is applied to the first flip-flop. The output of first flip-flop is used as the clock input for the second flip-flop. Now, how this circuit will function? Suppose initially all the flip-flops are reset to 0. So initially you get here 0 and here also 0. If you designate your output as B, A, then your A output is also 0. This is A and this is B. Or you can put Q, B or Q, A. So now initially the output of flip-flops are 0, 0. And under that condition your clock is also 0. When you apply the first clock pulse, as for the JK flip-flop, it will toggle at the state 1, 1. So initially it was 0. When you apply the clock pulse, it will toggle to the 1 state. Like that, when you apply the first clock pulse, it will show 0, 1. Similarly, when you apply the second clock pulse, it will show 1, 0. The contents of your flip-flop will be 1, 0. Then when you apply the third clock pulse, the contents of your flip-flop will be 1, 1. But when you apply the fourth clock pulse, again you are getting 0, 0. When you apply the fifth clock pulse, you are again start counting from 0, 1. Then next, again that process will repeat. So from that we will be concluded, this counter has the capability of maximum count of 2, 1, 1. Or total number of sequence, 4. So like that, just like we have explained, we can draw the timing diagram. Your truth table and timing diagram directly indicates the function of this counter. And also, if you have the fundamental of working principle of JK flip-flop, particularly at the J equal to 1 and K equal to 1, this is nothing for you. So how your timing diagram? First of all, to show the operation in terms of timing diagram, you have to minimum take the 6 clock pulses or more you can take. Then, as for the symbol, we are putting a bubble and a cap. So this indicates your flip-flop is triggered, negative edge triggered. If you don't have any bubble, that indicates your flip-flop is positive triggered or changes state as the positive edge. So as for our case, bubble means our flip-flop will change state at the negative, negative edges because negative triggered. So now see, the first flip-flop will change state at each negative edge of the clock input because this clock input is directly applied to the first flip-flop. So your first flip-flop will change state, at each negative edge of the clock input. Now verify, your first flip-flop is changing at each negative of the clock input. Similarly, the output of flip-flop A is acting as the input for the second flip-flop. So, your second flip-flop will change state at each negative of the output of first flip-flop. So now see, your second flip-flop output, initially it was 0, but at the negative edge, it will change to 1, and that 1 will continue up to next negative of A. Please consider this. This is the clock input for the next. So at the negative, again it returns to 0. Then next, it continue this 0. When it get the another positive, it will change to 1. This process will continue. So finally, if you check at each instant, after 1 clock pulse, your truth table is completely displayed here. Only one example I am taking here. You are applying the first clock pulse. Now see the position of your flip-flop outputs. After first clock pulse, now check at this instant or as per the indication. Now see, I am showing you just after the first clock pulse. What is the situation? Now this output is at 0, this output is at 1. So what is the reading? 0, 1. After first clock pulse. And what is the reading after first clock pulse? 0, 1. Similarly, after the second clock pulse, now see your second flip-flop output is at 1 and first flip-flop output is at 0. So accordingly, 1, 0. Your contents is 1, 0. Similarly, you can design the mod 8 or 3-bit counter. If you will be clear about it, about the first one, you can design or implement any higher order designs. Just only you have to know the meaning of the designation. Here mod 8 means total number of counting sequence is 8. And it can count from 0 to last count is 7. Number of counting sequence is 8. But starts from 0, accordingly last count is 7. But in terms of a bit, it has 3 bits because 8 is equal to 2 to the power 3. So accordingly, number of a bit equal to number of flip-flops. So directly take 3 flip-flops. Then how we connect the flip-flops? Same process. First, all the J and K inputs short-circuited and connected to the logic 1. As a result, all the flip-flops are getting J equal to 1, K equal to 1. Symbol notation you can use as for your choice. This is just a sample. You can put directly J, K or anything. Or you can put JX, KX like that as per your choice. 3 flip-flop is must and all the J and K inputs should be short-circuited and connected to the logic 1. That is must. Particularly focusing over the series counter. I will tell you later what is the modification for different designs. The next process for series counter is now J and K input connection is over. Then how we apply the clock input? Main source clock input is first of all applied to the first flip-flop directly. Now see, in before case also, you are applying directly to first flip-flop. In this case also, you are applying directly to the first flip-flop. That is a must in case of series. Then, output of a first acts as the clock input for the second. Output of a second acts as the clock input for the third. Now, clock connection over. Next, we have to show the output terminal. Each flip-flop output is taken to the outside for output terminal from each side. And this is your MSB, this is next, and this is your LSB bit. Three outputs. So in case of 3-bit counter, 3 flip-flops, 3 outputs. In case of 2-bit counter, 2 flip-flop, 2 outputs. Then same process. It's a truth table contains 8 number of sequences starting from 0 to 7. So if you apply a clock input, initially your clock 0 and all contents are 0. When you apply the first clock pulse, you are getting this reading. And like that, last count will be 111. When you apply the 8th number of clock pulse, it will again return to the 000. When you apply the 9th clock pulse, it will start again 001. When you apply the 10th clock pulse, again it will show 010. That means this process will continue. And from this, we can be very clear. Or it is a mod 8 counter. Suppose you have, from starting you are unknown completely. Then by testing, you can find out what is the last count of your given counter or unknown counter. And just like in before case, at each negative of the main clock source flip-flop A is changing. And at each negative of first flip-flop output, second flip-flop output is changing. And at the each negative of second flip-flop, third flip-flop output is changing. Same process. Only number process is more. And if you test, your truth table will directly satisfy this. After first clock pulse, now see, after first clock pulse, your C is at 0, your B is at 0, and your A is at 1. So 0, 0, 1 is your reading. Similarly, after second clock pulse, this is 0, this is 1, this is 0. So 0, 1, 0. Directly, your truth table will be displayed in terms of timing diagram. If you get any difference, then somewhere we are putting some error. So, just like mod 2 and mod 3, 2 bit or mod 4 counter and 4 bit or 3 bit or mod 8 counter, similarly for you one assignment, try to implement mod 4, please tell me why, mod 4, mod 4 means 2 bit. Either we take mod 16 or 4 bit counter assignment for you. Your assignment for the next class, just like your mod 4 or mod 8, you have to implement mod 16 counter or 4 bit counter. I will verify in class, then we shift to the next proceeding over the asynchronous or parallel, shift over the synchronous or parallel counter. This counter already we have finished, and alternative names. Alternative names are asynchronous counter, because we are not applying clock pulse at a time. Also known as the serial counter, we are applying in serial. Also known as the repeal counter, because your clock pulse is flowing like a, or passing like a repeal. So the alternative names for this is serial, repeal and asynchronous. But for parallel counter, parallel or synchronous counter. That is your next class. So thank you everybody.